I'm Jeff Philbin, and this is Dinner Diaz. Ideas for dinner for you. Today, curry braised oxtail with collard greens, brought to us by a very special guest who, let's just say, is someone that I kind of look up to because we're tag teaming it in the kitchen. Stay tuned. Joining me today is a man who's better known in the ring than in the kitchen. He's an athlete, an entertainer, a philanthropist, an author, a father, and today he's cooking for us. You probably know him best as WWE Global Ambassador Titus O'Neil, a.k.a. Thaddeus Bullard. And please, my friend, welcome to the Dinner Diaz kitchen, man.
Oh, well, thanks for having me.
You're sharing one of your favorite recipes with us, curry braised oxtail with collard greens.
Oxtails are high, too.
Oh, totally.
I don't know. I mean, it used to be the cheapest thing you can find. I'm looking forward to, you know, putting this together. So you first got to start off with curry.
Okay.
Sugar. Combine all of those.
Mm-hmm.
I need a fork.
Okay.
Since you're my sous chef.
Boom.
And then I have
some
sugar here.
Yep. There's a little stir.
I'll let you go ahead and because you need to work too.
You know, hey, you know what I mean?
Worked out this morning. I did my 5:30 workout this morning. I don't know what you did.
5:30 workout for today?
This morning. It usually is around 5, you know.
And then we're gonna get these with a nice coating, and then we're gonna put these into the fridge, right?
Yep, correct. We're gonna put them in the fridge. They're gonna soak in the fridge. I'll stay in the fridge overnight if you can, 12 to 24 hours. Just so that this seasoning can settle on them.
Mm-hmm.
And then...
So you want time to really kind of penetrate and get some flavor.
Yeah, this is not something you're just going to go in the kitchen and just whip up. You know? This is something that you got to plan and prepare for it because it is a process to do them right.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know how everybody out there be doing the oxtails. It's kind of like collard greens. It's a process.
It's a process.
Which we're going to make some collard greens too.
So. I can't wait. You're a big family man.
Yes, I am. And being able to do things like this, cook for my family, cook with my family, my kids. You know, I got three amazing children, TJ, Titus, and Leah Bullard. She's going to go to college at Oakland.
Dude, they're almost as tall as you, all of them.
My daughter is a basketball player. I adopted her a couple years ago, and she's been an amazing addition to our family. She's going to be going to college on a full scholarship to play basketball at Oakland University. And then my youngest son will be going to University of Florida and following my legacy there, along with his uncle's legacy. And then, you know, obviously my oldest son, TJ, is going into his junior year at UCF as a football player there. So I paid a lot of money for them to go to high school.
But it's been worth it. It's all worth it.
Yeah.
And you get to be able to enjoy that time and that experience. And now they've got great opportunities to
Absolutely.
Be able to. Now these are gonna go back into the
fridge. We're gonna put them right back into the bowl. They'll go in the fridge. They're already coated. They'll settle in there for 12 to 24 hours, depending on, you know, how long you wanna, have them settle, and we'll come back. So we'll put these bad boys in the refrigerator.
Nice.
In the bowl.
It's fun to be able. Like, do you enjoy when you're not on the road being able to just have those moments in the kitchen, though?
Yeah.
I mean, is it fun to really kind of get down and cook?
People always ask me all the time, like, what do I do in my free time? Which I don't have a whole lot of free time. But what I do in my free time is this is very therapeutic to me. Cooking is like one of my favorite things to do. I grew up in poverty, so didn't really have a whole lot of options to cook as a kid, but. Once I, you know, as I got older and I started traveling the world and trying different foods around different restaurants, it definitely opened up my palate for food.
People would think you'd have a private chef doing this all the time. And you're saying, nah, man, I'm in the kitchen. No, I'm doing this. I'm bringing
cooking.
It all together.
So as you see, you got it right here, ladies and gentlemen. You got them all. Yeah, give me that right there. You see they all in a Ziploc here. We'll go to our fridge.
All right.
Put them in the refrigerator and they'll settle.
And now these ones have already been inside the refrigerator overnight.
Okay.
Move this out of the way for you, give a little more space.
And the pan is already hot because my lovely short sous chef over here has made sure that the pan was hot.
This is a sous chef. I mean, I already know.
I think we need to twins show, like twins,
You know, bringing it all back, you
Danny
know?
DeVito,
I think we can do that.
You know, you definitely can play Danny DeVito in this.
Uh-oh.
You know what I mean?
I'm Danny DeVito now. We got Arnold Schwarzenegger, Danny DeVito over here.
Tilt this,
you know, because people often get us confused.
They do.
You do know that, right?
Yeah.
Everyone is like, oh, wow.
Guys, look at us, you know what I mean? And he always has on a pair of fresh kicks, too.
Yes, that part, we do have that in common.
Let me see that pot holder, so I want to move this oil around a little bit.
Sure. I got you.
Yep. So we can have a little easy.
And this was just a neutral oil that we just added in.
Yeah, grapeseed oil.
Mm-hmm.
You only want to have these on for like maybe 2 minutes each side.
Yeah.
You just want to braise it so that the actual seasoning can stick to each side.
And it smells fantastic right now. Man. You get all that curry powder, brown sugar, the white sugar, you know, it's definitely going to make that beautiful crust that you're going to start seeing over here. And that's just to lock in and sear those flavors.
Correct, yeah. So if you want to give me a little bit of, move that oil a little bit more again so we can get a little even side of the oil. All right. I want them to be beautiful on each side.
Look at that. You know, I gotta ask you this. Mm-hmm. What do you typically eat to stay in shape? I mean, you're at the gym at 5:30. You're already beating me.
Yeah, I eat everything.
You eat everything.
What time do you go to the gym?
What time you want me to go next time with you? I gotta get back in?
You don't go to the gym. You know, the gym's not your thing. It's okay.
It's not for everybody, bro. All right, so are you telling me that if I do go, you'll help me?
I will help you.
And actually, like, get me back into that whole pathway.
100%. 100%.
I got someone to spot me then. Yay.
So we're going to deglaze the pan here.
All right, so then all we're going to do here is just going to add a little bit of white wine. Just loosen up everything that's on the bottom here.
You can do any brand you choose, white wine, just to deglaze the pan.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're going to keep some of those.
All those little brown bits are just going to be absolutely beautiful flavor here.
Yep.
Oh, they're just now going to lift right off?
Yep.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
What do we have to do to get more flavor in there then?
We're going to end up adding our carrots, our celery.
Mm-hmm. Now, are you a recipe follower? I like to blaze my own path and just go with what is
I used to be a recipe follower when I first started.
Yeah.
But once I started learning what my taste palate was and what people around me's taste palate was, it's a lot easier for me to just say, all right, we're going to do this instead.
So all these vegetables are now just going to sweat a little bit. They're just going to just soften a little bit.
Yeah.
And then time to add the curry paste?
Curry paste.
Okay.
Yeah. Add curry paste here. It's Thai curry paste is what it calls for.
Okay.
You can use green or red. I mean, again, it all depends on what you want to add to it. And the seasonings as well. You can add more seasonings to this. You can do a little bit of thyme, a little bit of rosemary. It all depends on what you want. The red curry paste obviously is gonna help you have a more reddish broth.
Mm-hmm.
The green curry paste will have you do a little darker broth. But if you add browning gravy, it doesn't matter which curry paste you use. It's all gonna come out a little bit browner.
I love it, because to make this for your dinner, just hit up Thaddeus on Instagram. He's gonna drop by the house to make it for you. I know he's busy. You ain't gonna do that?
No, bro.
All right, well, he's not gonna do that, but we do have
unless you wanna pay. Unless you wanna pay.
All right.
I do have a foundation, you know, bulletfamilyfoundation.org. So if you wanna make a generous donation.
So a generous donation will get you that. Or if you cannot do it, we do have his recipe with all the ingredients and the directions, as he mentioned, ready for you to grab over at dinnerdeeas.com. Just get your phone out, open the camera app, and point at the QR code in the corner of the screen, and a link to us will pop up. All right. Now, what do we have to do next here?
Oh, then we just take the oxtails and we drop them back into the broth.
Perfect. And while these simmer, we're going to take a break. And when we come back, Titus tackles finishing this up and getting it into the oven and shares his tips for a tasty side of collard greens ahead on Dinner Diaz. Welcome back to Dinner Diaz. Today, we're joined in the kitchen by a big star in every sense of the word, WWE Global Ambassador Titus O'Neil, a.k.a. Thaddeus Bullard. He's here to make one of his favorite dishes, curry braised oxtail with collard greens. And before the break, we season our oxtails and let them marinate before we sear them and deglaze with a little white wine. We cooked it up with some carrots, some celery, and some onions, and we mixed in that beautiful curry paste. And during the break, it's been reducing by about half.
Yep, now next step, we're gonna add our chicken stock. as well as our coconut milk.
Look at that. That looks absolutely fantastic.
And then you'll
get and the smells already.
Yeah, you'll give it a quick stir here. Obviously, you want to stir it nice and easy so you're not splashing all over.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's beautiful. And now, this is going to go into the oven now.
It's going to go in the oven right now, 325 for right at 4 hours. We'll put them in the oven here. Oven's already preheated at 325.
Perfect.
Now, four hours.
Now, we know oxtails are something that you do like. Some of the dishes that you don't like. You had like this whole thing with Thanksgiving, man.
Oh yeah.
For all my friends that want to present some things I don't eat, and I'm not welcome in my home. One is sweet peas. I grew up poor. I had to eat sweet peas all the time. Egg noodles. Don't give me nothing that consists of egg noodles. And then, last but not least, don't send me no casserole.
I just think, you know, I don't really trust people what they put in their casserole. You know what I mean?
It's kind of like just like, is it just like a whole throw everything in and just hope it's gonna be good?
Well, that and then, you know, growing up, you know, I went to the Florida Sheriff's Youth Ranch as a kid. One of the favorite go-tos for the moms and pops at the boys' ranch was casserole. So I had every kind of casserole, green bean casserole, sweet potato casserole, which is actually one of my favorite things. And then, you know, they just started getting outrageous. I had one person bring over, Ricky, what was the name of that?
Pineapple casserole.
Pineapple casserole. You know who you are out there. Came over to the house, but most of the people that came over with these casseroles or that I visited their home were not African American, if you know what I mean. They were more on your end of the spectrum.
I get it.
White people love some casseroles.
And we're starting on the collard greens right now, and all we just started was we brought back that grapeseed oil, so just a very neutral, high heat oil in the bacon. To get an authentic WWE dinner on your table tonight, you can find Titus's recipe at our website, dinnerdeeas.com. Just scan the QR code to get there. And that looks like it's just gonna brown, and we're gonna take a quick break. When we come back, we'll be finishing up our side and our oxtails ahead on Dinner Diaz. Welcome back to Dinner Diaz. Joining me for a dinner of champions is an actual champion himself from the WWE, Thaddeus Bullard, aka WWE Global Ambassador Titus O'Neil. He's been with us and sharing one of his favorite recipes with us, which is curry braised oxtail with collard greens. Before the break, we added some chicken stock, some coconut milk to our oxtails and got them into the oven. And we fried up some bacon for these collard greens here. And so,
so you see the bacon is
crispy, nice, beautiful color.
Yeah,
so that was fantastic. What's next then?
Add the collard greens.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and while I'm preparing these, if you don't mind, I ask you to take out a little bit of butter and flour because I want you to make a roux.
Okay.
For me, I know you know how to make that.
I can, chef. I can have a little fun here.
You know what I mean? So we're gonna add a little salt, a little sugar.
Sugar. All right.
Sugar. Got the sugar here. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, can you smell what Thaddeus is cooking?
All right.
You know, yeah, I stole the rock thing real quick. You know, it's all right.
It's all right. He's friends.
He likes the arena full of people saying it. You know what I mean? Then you do a little salt bay action with the salt. You know what I mean? You see that?
All right. Actually, what is that really like? To hear your name be chanted with that many people, you know, all over the globe. Like, what is that feeling like?
It's awesome in the arena, but when you're walking around town, it can be a little frustrating.
Yeah.
Because sometimes I'm just trying to get to go eat. You mix this up a little bit. You got a little bit of pepper, salt and pepper. You don't need an over-seasoned green. Greens kind of take care of themselves. You can see there, ladies and gentlemen, look at these greens. Look how they're looking. Just look at it, guys. Look at her. As you can see, I cooked these greens down to make them as tender as possible.
Mm-hmm.
So that when I get ready to add the chicken stock just brings everything together. You keep it cooking medium to high heat. medium high heat. Give me that cover right there.
Cut.
We're gonna let these things simmer a little bit.
There we go.
All right, we're gonna let them things simmer up a little bit. You got my roux
going
good?
I got the roux ready. I got the roux ready.
So we're gonna check on these oxtails now. They should be done. Remember now, this is TV, guys.
Now, these have been in the oven for 4 hours.
For 4 hours.
325.
325.
These look... But these are very forgiving, you were saying. So these could stay in longer than that if you want to.
If you kept them in longer, the only thing they're going to do is get even more tender.
Absolutely beautiful. Look how beautiful that looks.
Voila. I mean, you can't get much better than that there, so go ahead and stir them up there.
That looks absolutely
good. Let the people see, you know.
Look at this.
Look how tender they are.
Oh my gosh, look at that. And you know what's going to be really nice is that because we have that roux here, now we can actually make like a nice little bit of like a gravy with it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and so that's what we're going to do here. We're just going to take all of this right from the bottom here, and we're just going to just ladle this slowly in to get this on your table for your dinner. Grab the recipe at our website, dinnerdeeAs.com. Just scan the QR code to get there. Would you like to do the honors of plating?
Yeah, why not?
Come on, my friend. Show me how it's done.
All right.
And then we also still have that nice little bit of a gravy here that we just thickened with all of those beautiful flavors from what you had just done. Oh, come on now. Ooh, this looks too good. When we come back, we're going head to head in a knockout bout, slamming chairs into each other.
Chairs. Wait. I didn't agree to that.
You didn't? Tables?
No, not either.
You want to sit at the table with me then?
We can sit at the table.
Fantastic.
Absolutely.
Well, we're going to sit at the table.
I'm off the clock with the wrestling. I can tell you that right now. Won't be no ladders, no tables, no chairs. It's just food, fun, and we're going to talk. That's it.
We're going to be dignified, civil gentlemen.
Yes.
Coming up ahead on Dinner Diaz.
Oof. Tables and chairs. Well, you have lost your mind.
Welcome back to Dinner Diaz. Yeah. It is who you think it is, Titus O'Neil, my friends, or to close friends, Thaddeus Bullard. He is the WWE Global Ambassador, and we've been making his signature dish, curry braised oxtail with the collard greens. Dude, I can't wait to get into this. Can we just go straight in?
And I intermittent fasted just to try to get to this part.
You
right
intermittent fasted just to get to this
just
moment?
Just to get to this moment.
So where are you going first? You're going with
collard
greens
first? Greens,
I'm going to follow your lead on this one, actually, because I'm very intrigued.
That boy good. Hey, that boy good.
It really
chef,
is.
You're a chef. You got the.
It really is. The bacon is absolutely fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
You have a beautiful layer of just that smokiness that you want, the texture behind it. But what was the really interesting piece? That sugar.
Mm-hmm.
It has nice that nice little bit of a sweetness behind it. That's kind of exciting.
Yeah. Takes the bitterness.
It takes
the
bitterness away from it because then now. I mean, why did I even bring a knife out? I don't even know why I did that, dude. Because, like, look.
Fall off the bone.
It is falling right off the bone.
Yeah, off the bone. Look at that.
Oh, wow.
Hey, this is special.
It really
is. I can go to sleep right now.
This is the comfort food?
I've been waiting on this all day long.
It's not spicy.
At all. Beautiful. You can make them spicy.
You could, but this does not have any heat behind it like that. You've absolutely perfected the season.
Ladies and gentlemen,
that marinade
is
really good.
I highly, highly suggest you guys go to dinnerdeeaz.com, get this recipe, and please yourself because it is a slice of heaven.
It is a slice
right
of heaven.
Right here on earth.
And many will say that for what you do for others, because your story is so inspiring. You know, someone who came from basically nothing to not only the fame and the fortunes that you have now, but you're doing great things with the platform that you're on with it. You know, you've been described as one of the most philanthropic superstars in WWE history. And you got the school named after you. How does that feel to see your name up there, knowing that you're impacting the lives of kids every day?
Well, I'll say it time and time again, if the people didn't make investments in me years ago when they didn't expect anything in return, they didn't even know I was there. They just invested in a place and a vision of helping kids that were in underserved communities, underserved situations, bad situations, trauma-filled situations. And these kids that reside in the zip code of 33610 are no different than I was when I was a kid, being a product of a sexual assault, mother having me at 12 years old, you know, being labeled a kid that would be dead or in jail by the time I was 16, all the odds were definitely stacked against me. Much like a lot of the kids that even right here in our beautiful Tampa Bay area community, there are a lot of kids that have a lot of odds stacked against them. And being able to work with Hillsborough County School District, not just at this school in particular, but throughout the entire region, has been nothing short of a treat. The board has been very supportive of what we're trying to do here, because if we can get it right here at, you know, the Thaddeus and Bullard Academy at Sly Middle Magnet School, it opens up doors for us to go to another school.
You could be living up the life of luxury, but you just decided, nah, man, there's something bigger than just me.
Well, I can't say that I decided. I said I can say.
You're doing something with it, and you're giving back to others. My dad always taught me, when you give, you receive. And that's a beautiful thing that you are giving to others. Thanks for coming on to the show. Thank you so much for the recipe. Thanks again to this stunt double here, guys. My look-alike, Thaddeus Bullard, a.k.a. WWE.
Just a lot of all these
people. Titus O'Neil. I'm not lying to them. I can't lie to them because I'm going to give them the truth. And the truth is, a link to the website and his recipe are at dinnerdeeas.com. So if you make it, send us a photo and let us know how it turned out.
I'm just tag me.
Tag!
At Titus O'Neil WWE. Tag
at
Jeff. Tag the show.
Chef Feldman. Let's have some fun.
We'll repost
together.
It. Yeah, we'll repost it.
Thanks for watching and see you next time with more Dinner Deeas. Stump double.